Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sitting here with Marvin Masa, and we're just gonna ask him a few questions and start off by saying, hey, we're just giving God the praise. It's all about God. It's not about him right now, but we're just interviewing him right now. So the word gospel, what does that mean to you?
The word gospel to me means the present change in my life, the present change in my mind, in my heart, because it's only through the gospel and hearing the truth that changed me and set me free from my old ways, to allow me to share with other people my story, my own personal story, through the gospel, and knowing what I've gone through can change other people as well.
Okay, so you mentioned what you've been through. So what is a brief description of the Marvin Masa story? Like,
okay.
Where you from, you know, what happened? Some people always say it was a drastic change or I was near-death experience, you know, before I found the Lord, but just tell us about Marvin.
Yeah, so born and raised in Michigan, been in and outside of the Detroit metropolitan area throughout my entire life through my first 18 years. And then just being in that area, what kept me out of trouble in the beginning was I was in Taekwondo. And it got to the point where I was doing it at a high competitive level. Junior Olympics, on the verge of going to the 2012 Beijing Olympics. And I ended up quitting because when I got to high school, I didn't really have friends because I was so focused on that I wanted to fit in with the crowd. And they would make fun of me for doing it. So I ended up quitting to fit in with the crowd. And a thing that led up to that was I was always a person who was in my feelings. So if I felt a certain way or I was looking for this certain type of satisfaction, I thought it was going to be in finding friends. 10th grade comes around. On top of doing Taekwondo, I also did basketball. About half the time, I did Taekwondo for about 12 years, and then basketball for about 6. 10th grade year is like, okay, well, I have these friends, but I'm still looking for the satisfaction. Let me go see if it's in basketball. Let me go pursue sports. And I'm making a high school team, playing AAU, traveling around the Midwest and Canada playing basketball, but that wasn't the satisfaction I was looking for.
Yep, feel.
11th grade comes around, I'm like, okay, well maybe it's not in friends, it's not in sports, maybe it's in girls. So I ended up getting my heart broken, which in turn, I started breaking other girls' hearts and started messing around more than I should have. Still didn't find that satisfaction, still looking for this hole. Senior year comes around, I'm like, okay, well, I'm gonna just do me, focus on basketball, I got scholarships on the way out. So did that, but every year in high school, I would go through seasons. It would be athletic stage, I'd cut my hair, stay focused, stay in the books, and then as soon as that season was over, I would grow my hair out, hang out with my old friends, start smoking, start drinking, fall back into that this seasonal lifestyle every year in high school. As soon as senior year was over, I fell back into that, even worse than I had the years prior.
So it kept getting deeper and deeper.
Kept getting deeper and deeper in the drugs, the alcohol. And next thing you know, the summer's over. I miss the camps. I miss signing to the colleges. I'm not going to college anymore. I'm a 17-year-old kid in Detroit, not knowing what to do. And the only thing I resorted to was music. I made music. I started fiddling around with it in 9th grade, 10th grade. And since everything was out of the picture, I'm like, well, let's go full force with this. Me and a few of my boys, there's about 5 of us, we're 16, 17, 18 years old, we formed a group. And in that group, we started putting out mixtapes, we started to get serious with it, we started doing out shows all around southeastern Michigan, and then sometimes even in the western part of Michigan, in Flint. And we started getting a little buzz going. We started getting on the radio, we started getting paid from the show, 16, 17, 18 year old kids. And things started going bad at home with me and my mom. My dad was actually in Virginia because he's a police officer and he had training here. So for that summer, my dad was gone and I was under my mom. And on top of me not going to college, me not having a job, along with my father figure not there that summer, me and my mom bashed heads. And since we started progressing through music, I'm like, I'm going to give up. Fine. 16, 17, 18 year old kids get an apartment together off money making music in Detroit. Deeper, we fell in deeper. Next thing you know, I'm caught up on even harder drugs. 6 months of my life flashed by like that. It wasn't about the music anymore, it was about this image that we were upholding. This, we're making money, we're getting girls, doing this, doing that, rappers. And I woke up 6 months later, like, what am I doing with my life? Had this epiphany. Moved in back home with my mom, my dad, and then quitting all the drugs and not being sober, cold turkey, the withdrawals were crazy. I felt like I was being possessed. I was afraid of colors, numbers, left, right, up, down. I was afraid of sleeping. I was afraid of everything. 6 months of being under the influence to nothing. I was smoking a pack, two packs of cigarettes a day to try and calm myself down. And then I was on the computer one night, this was about a 2 week period, and I wanted to commit suicide. But I didn't have enough to go that full route. And there was one night where I Googled how to find Christ. Don't know why, but I Googled how to find Christ.
So through all the drugs, everything, the withdrawal, it's like you had a moment of clarity.
A moment of clarity.
Not knowing where it came from.
Mm-hmm. Woke up one morning, moved in back home, the withdrawals, and then on the computer.
And Google
how to find Christ.
Then what happened? Okay.
At first I was skeptical because it was like, you give your heart to me, then your soul will be saved. In my mind, I'm like, oh, I'm about to join the Illuminati right now. Like, I was like, well, I mean, I'm in this, I like to call that time of my life my darkest hour. And I was in this dark corner of my life where there's no way out. And I was like, well, I mean, even if I did, whatever, it's not gonna be worse than what I'm going through right now.
Right.
So I said the prayer, and instantly this like 10,000 ton weight off my shoulders was lifted. And I started feeling, back then I thought it was a high. Back then I was like, oh, this is the best high I've ever felt. What is going on right now? I went into, started freaking out. I went to my car, smoked a few cigarettes back to back, like trying to calm myself down. What is going on right now? And through that 6 month period of me being on drugs, the only thing that stood out that moment was when I would talk to my dad on the phone, you asked me how I was doing. And him being a man of God, he would always tell me, just read the Bible, read the Bible. As soon as that moment happened, those words instantly just started going through my head.
Read the Bible, read the Bible.
Downloaded the Bible app on my iPhone 4, I think it was at the time. Started the Read the Bible in 90 Days plan. Started reading, went from now my earrings, my lip piercing, shaving my head, ended up joining the Navy. And here I am today, a new person.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, that's a story. Google. How to find Christ. All right. So now you got your music. Now you're making beats now. You're a rescue swimmer in the Navy, saving lives.
Yep.
So, who are you trying to reach? Like, which age group, or is it just everybody? Or what do you want them to know?
Well, with my last project that I put out last year, it was basically people knowing that I'm not who I used to be.
Right.
Now that that foundation is laid, now that they know my agenda, I really want to go towards young people because I'm seeing the generation nowadays coming up. It's dark. And my sister, who isn't saved, is part of that generation. So knowing that I can witness to these people, just share with them my own personal story, and hopefully change some hearts, change some lives along the way with fulfilling this purpose. Because in the beginning, I resisted with God of doing music again because it ended so bad. And it's about a year and a half, 2 year period where okay, fine, I see what you're now that I've surrendered, I see what he's trying to do.
So for the youth or the teenagers or whoever that may be watching, that's going through their dark times or don't even know it's a dark time in life, if you could tell them anything, what would you tell them?
No matter how hard it is, no matter how dark it is, how dark it gets, how depressed you feel, how you feel on the inside, tomorrow's a new day. And sometimes we're not even promised tomorrow. So there's something you gotta do right here, right now to change your mindset, to think in a different perspective, to look at it from a different angle, so you don't go over the border, you don't go and boil over.
So before you hit that brick wall, before death start knocking on your door, you need to decide again. All right, so you got videos, you got CDs. If somebody want to get in touch with you, what do they need to do?
For all my contact information, straight through to the RodspannTV.com website. Got my own personal website for that. Got Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, Beats, all the licensing information, all of my graphic design services, features. Any sort of contact information, everything is on there. That's basically the medium to everything else that spider webs to Marvin and the team and we do Marvin.
All right, well, I appreciate you taking the time out. I got my own little testimony about how I met him, but that'll be another time. But this is it. This is actually the first interview that we're doing right here. RodspannTV, the good news.
Yeah.
So you'll see all of the contact information at the bottom, how to get in contact with them. Hit them up, need some beats or want them to be on your track, whatever it may be. Just look up all the information. And that's it. We're cool. Done. Appreciate you, brother. Be blessed.
Thanks.
All right. God.